Evansville able to come away victorious here today as they knock off Central Arkansas 3-0. We're joined now in the Golf Plus postgame show by our man of the match, Landon Souter. And Landon, it was an important one tonight. I know you guys had a tough match against against SIUE on Monday, but what does it mean to your team to be able to bounce back and get the win here tonight against Central Arkansas?
We needed it. We needed this win. We needed to come out, have fun during the game, just play as hard as we could and compete. That's what we talked about all week in practice, was just competing. That's what we did tonight.
Now, I know you were able to step up, score a goal. Take us through that run. You started about 35, 40 yards out from goal. What was going through your mind when you first got that ball?
Well, I was thinking about switching the ball, but then I took a touch in and saw Mark Gonzalez, gave it to him, and then just kept running off. I saw some space and got in behind, and just I scored. Just kind of amazed myself.
Well, you were able to pop it up over the goalkeeper. Now, take us through the celebration. I mean, it goes back in the net. You're not necessarily a goal scorer, at least not at the college level. What was with the celebration?
Well, I talked to Ryan Koenig, another player on the team, before. He said I was going to score tonight. I said I'm going to go run, slide into him. So that's what I did. I had a follow-up on my what I told him I was going to do.
Well, there you go. You were able to follow up. Now for you defensively, I know you played a couple different roles tonight. You were able to come in, play in that defensive midfield role that you usually hold, but also were able to be the anchor that usually Patrick Hodges is. Can you just talk about the importance of being in that spot and being able to keep this defense and get the clean sheet?
It was huge. It's huge, honestly, just to get Pat some rest. I mean, he always plays 90 minutes regardless of the game. So it was just big for us to come in and get him some rest so he can make it through the whole season.
Now you guys will be back in Valley action again next week at Bradley. Obviously you're trying to make it two wins in a row here in Valley play. You know, what do you guys need to do to be successful against the Braves?
Just come out this week, practice hard, and just like we did today, just simple, come out and compete.
Valley Conference play. We're joined now by Associate Head Coach Marshall Ray. And Coach, you know, we talked about this game even on Monday about the importance of bouncing back here tonight and getting some momentum. You guys were able to do that. Just talk about what your team was able to do here tonight.
Well, we had an important week. You know, I think when you have some games like we had, we were able to get together as a group and talk about some things and get things sorted out. So, you know, I think from a character standpoint and some things, we got some issues sorted out, and it showed on the field tonight. I mean, we got out there, and I think everyone, you know, gave 100%, and we're fighting for each other. And we told the guys when those things happen, it doesn't matter about tactics or how we're playing or what we're doing. We've just got to be able to compete, and we did that tonight.
Yeah, you guys were able to do that, able to put some early pressure on. It seemed like the front three for you, Macias, Terry, and Gonzalez, really set the tone for you. Can you just talk about what they were able to do up top, especially against Central Arkansas, that seemed to be holding a high offside trap line against you guys?
Yeah, they're definitely holding that high line, and we were able to play through midfield as well, and I think that opened some things up. So, you know, we're getting balls moving through midfield, and we're a bit more dynamic up front. They just weren't straight runs. Guys were making runs in, and, you know, and diagonal runs, getting on the inside shoulder of their outside backs and some things like that, instead of just running straight up and down the field. And, you know, our ability to keep the ball in the midfield allowed us to make, you know, time those runs a little bit better, and we just weren't as direct as we had been. You know, we kept the ball. That's going to allow you to shift their backs a little bit and open up some gaps to get into. And so, you know, from front to back, we were just much better and comfortable on the ball, and it showed. And, you know, we were able to get behind them, and there's no question those three give us the ability to get behind teams with the pace they have.
And then you guys were able to take them off at the start of the second half, put them back on, and then it was a player that hasn't scored for you that really kind of changed the tone of the match. Talk about Landon Souter's run, though. I mean, he started about 35, 40 yards out, and he even said that he was thinking first to switch the ball. Good thing he didn't switch the ball.
Yeah, Landon's capable of that. He's athletic. He's got good pace, and he's deceptive a little bit, so he can take a first touch and get past some guys. So, you know, he eats things up in midfield for us defensively, and, you know, I think – the more comfortable we get with him making some of those runs forward, he'll be able to do a little bit more. And when he does it, he's hard to keep up with. And he made a great run, a good little give and go, and then he got stuck into that tackle that ended up in the back of the net. He may claim it's a shot, but, you know, we'll take it. And we were teasing him the other day because he scored an ugly goal in training, and he said they all count. So I'm sure you're thinking that as well today when he scored.
Now you guys will continue in Valley play a matchup against the Bradley Braves, always a very tough matchup because they play a style unlike any other in the Valley. How important is next Saturday's match for you guys?
You know, we've talked about it from the start of our conference season. You know, we're 1-1 right now in conference play, and that's what's important. And the goal for us is to finish winning all the rest of our conference matches. You know, the rest of the season's important, but to do what we want to do, we need to put ourselves in a good spot going into the conference tournament and make sure that we qualify for it and hopefully compete for that first or second place bid so we can play Friday, Sunday instead of Wednesday, Friday, Sunday. So, you know, we've got a little time now. We can take a couple days off. The guys can get healthy. We can rest and regroup. And, you know, I can't say enough about the character of our group this week and how we fought and battled and sorted ourselves out. So that was a good thing for our group, a good thing for our program. And moving forward, we're going to go give Bradley, you know, everything we can and hopefully come back with a win and be 2-1 in conference and see what we can do from there.
All right. Congratulations on the win here tonight, Marshall. Go enjoy this one with the crew, and we'll talk to you guys when you return home. Best of luck at Bradley.
We appreciate it, and as always, appreciate the fans that came out tonight, and hopefully we'll see you again when we play Kentucky at home. And, you know, I think we've got a team to be proud of, so we're looking forward to getting back on the field.